Welcome back, students. Today, our class is for atmospheric instrument of to measure the atmospheric pressure. So this is called barometer. Barometer is a device which is used to calculate or find the atmospheric pressure. So it is a device used to measure the air pressure, a barometer, metric pressure at a given location. So what are the types? There are two types of barometers: mercury barometer and Android barometer. So here it is. If you look at the mercury barometer, mercury is filled inside a container. Atmospheric pressure reacts on the surface of the mercury, and this pushes this mercury to raise up to a certain height. Mercury column, where the mercury has to move, pressure exerted by the column of the mercury. This is the pressure exerted by the mercury, and partial evacuation column, upper surface is partially evacuated. So when you will immerse it inside, it is closed from the upper side, the front side is open, and this outer pressure exerting on the surface of this mercury will compel, force this mercury to rise up in this. And the height of the disc will be marked, height of this level of the mercury will be marked and divided into marks so that to measure accurate than the Android. This one is mercurial barometer, mercury field, and we will discuss during this class that what's the reason why we can't fill air inside, and we will discuss in detail what happens if we fill water inside this, use water as a source for measuring that pressure. So why we are using mercury? It has some benefits. More accurate than the Android. Invented by Priestley in 1643. Priestley. Next. 1 meter, 39 inches long glass tube sealed on one end. 39 inches means 1 meter. Open end is inverted in pool of mercury. Height of mercury changes as the pressure changes. This height of the mercury changes with the change of the pressure. Adjustments are required for temperature and altitude. We make some adjustments depending on temperature and altitude. Where it is, what happens? This is the vacuum from the upper side. This is the mercury. On both sides, that air pressure acts from this as well as from this side. This pressure will force this mercury to rise up to a certain height. So we will mark, we will get this mark at the level of the mercury depends on atmospheric pressure. It will be, if it is more, then it will rise up. If it is less, then of course it will move down. So here it is. How to measure the atmospheric pressure? By filling the barometer with mercury, it's inverted in a mercury trough. Mercury in the tube descends and stops at a certain height. The coulomb of mercury held in the tube exerts pressure at the base. At sea level, the height of the mercury coulomb above the mercury in the trough is found to be 76 centimeters. The pressure exerted by 76 centimeters is nearly 101,300 Newton per meter square, which is equal to the atmospheric pressure. So if you come back, look at the back side. This one is a figure. And if you look at, you have basically already filled this tube, and it is placed inverted inside a trough which already contains the mercury. What will happen due to the weight or the gravitational force? This mercury will move in downward direction in the trough. At the same time, to this side, this is a type of pressure which exerts on the open surface from this as well as from this. On right and left, this forces to stop the motion of the mercury to move down. A stage will come at sea level where there will be no motion of further mercury in downward direction. That is measured to be 76 centimeters. So this is basically atmospheric value of atmospheric pressure at sea level. Then we may convert into other types of the units, which is equal to 101,300 Newton per meter square. So at atmospheric pressure at a place does not remain constant. Hence, the height of the mercury column also varies with the atmospheric pressure. At sea level, the atmospheric pressure is about this one. This is the value of atmospheric pressure at sea level, but it will decrease when you move above the sea level up to a certain height. Why? Because there are a number of reasons. Concentration of the air molecule and other types of the particle suspension reduces. Because this earth is applying some force on the particle, they move closer to the earth surface. So here it is why mercury is used in barometer. So this is the reason. Mercury is 13.6 times denser than the water. This was the reason. Sometimes you may be asked, what's the reason why you are not using water instead of mercury? So this is the reason. If you have to use the water in place of the mercury, you have to take the longer length of the column of the tube. So to reduce this SL problem, use mercury. It becomes more easier for you to measure the pressure, atmospheric pressure. Atmospheric pressure can hold vertical column of water about 13.6 times the height of the mercury column at a place. So it will increase by 13.6 times because it is mercury is denser than this one. It will be having less, but the water which is about 13.6 times less denser, it will the height of the mercury will increase. Thus, at sea level, the vertical column of the water column will be multiply this 0.76 meter with 13.6. It will be 10.34 meter. It means you need such length of them length of that tube by 10.34 meter. So it's not possible to hold this length. So thus, a glass tube more than 10 meter long is required to make the water barometer. So this is the limitation. And these limitations are asked, you have to answer with the logic. What's the reason why you can't replace the mercury with the water filled tube? So this is the reason. Water is 13.6 times lighter, having less density than the mercury. Mercury is having more. So the length of the mercury column will be 13.6. And in case of water filled, the length of that mercury call that tube will be 10.34 meter, which is not possible to hold any 10 meter long tube, glass tube which is filled with the water. But here it is very much less in case of the mercury. With this, our class ends, and let's see the main points again. This is the reason why you can't reuse water in place of the mercury. Height of the water in case of the water filled tube, you need more than 10 meters, which is not possible to hold. Limitations are there, but in case mercury is 13.6 times denser than the water, so it becomes very easier due to less height of the mercury inside the tube to measure the pressure. So here it is, atmospheric pressure remains constant, and the height of the mercury column also varies with the atmospheric pressure. These were the points how to measure atmospheric pressure. These are the main points to note down. These are the techniques which are used to measure the atmospheric pressure. So here is the mercury barometer, how it acts, how it works. This is the simplest type of the principle on which it works. You fill mercury with the mercury, this tube, glass tube with the mercury. Already there is a tub which is containing the mercury. Hold it inverted inside the tub. This mercury will start moving down. A time will reach when there will be no motion of the mercury outside. Why? Because this is the time when this column is equal to this mercury. The force exerted by this mercury is equal to the force exerted by these air molecules on the surface. They balance each other, and there is no net motion of mercury in downward direction. So here it is. I thank you all for your patience. Hope you people have understood today's topic.